So you've recently been made an admin of the Power Platform tenant or environment. And you're wondering, where do I even begin? Well, this video, we're going to show you the top five things you should do immediately in your Power Platform environment if you're an admin of an environment or a tenant. So let's begin. First of all, you're looking at the make.powerapps.com environment. You're like, where do I go first? Same thing for make.powerautomate also. First thing to start with is go to the Admin Center. You can get there by hitting the gearbox up top and going to Admin Center. An alternative way to get there is aka.ms/Power Platform Admin Center, PPAC. That will also get you there as well. Once here, let's go to environments. Now, the first thing I always do when I get to a new environment is scrolling down, looking for where the default environment is. And you can also filter this and just show me the default environment. Now, in my case, it's named appropriately, but in most cases, it will be your company name and in parentheses, the word default. So what you're going to want to do is select this environment, whatever your default environment is, and this default environment is your junk drawer for your company. It contains all the rubbish that you have at the company, all the apps and all those kind of things that are not really meant for enterprise use. It should be meant for individual or small team usage. So I'm gonna go and open up my default environment, hit the edit button on the top right, and rename it as something like personal productivity. Now, this is going to make it to where you're stating the purpose of this environment. Now, it could be like Pragmatic Works, personal productivity, or something like that, but you want to keep it where it's stating the purpose of this is meant for just you to build something for you. Now, also here, this is like the equivalent of your OneDrive folder, for example, your personal OneDrive folder. Additionally, this URL could also be renamed. For example, I can call mine PW Personal Productivity, for example. Now, once I do this, it is not going to PM personal. There we go. Something like that. Now, when I hit save here, it will take about 30 seconds to go ahead and finish this operation, and it will not impact any existing applications or processes that may be running. So as it does this, it's going to keep the old name for a short period of time and the new name for a short period of time as well, or not for a long time. And it will take about 30 seconds to do this, and then you're all done. So this is a non-breaking operation by doing this. So now you can see the URL has been named, and you can also find that your environment has been renamed also. This is one of the first things I always do when I come here is making sure that the default environment has the word personal productivity somewhere in there to state its purpose. Number two thing you should do is go over to the settings panel on the left side and alter some really large settings. Oh, there we go. The first setting we want to look at is going to be production environment assignments. Now, there's a lot of settings in here I want to tweak, but these are the top three settings I want to do. First of all, production environment assignments. When I look at this, you'll see that in my case, only specific admins can do this. Now, these admins are going to be people like global admins, dynamics admins, and the power platform admin. Those three roles are allowed to create environments when I set up this. Now, by default, everyone will be able in your company to create a new environment. Now, these environments are like virtual machines almost at Microsoft. They contain all of your apps, your flows, your chatbots, your users, and a Dataverse database. Now, each environment doesn't cost you anything, but it does cost you a gig of Dataverse space, of capacity. And you only have a finite amount of space of capacity here. So if you leave this open and people doing classes and whatnot, they might spin up a whole bunch of environments and rob you of all of your space. And it's going to take you a long time as administrator to unwind that. So this is a top thing you should definitely do is set this to only specific admins. Now, you'll also see the same setting under trials. I always leave the trial environments open here in this case. By leaving it open, it's going to make it to where you're going to be able to allow your users to create trial environments for 30 days, and it does destroy itself after 30 days. You'll also find the developer assignment as well. This does not cost you anything either, as well as a trial environment does not cost you anything. This setting, again, I leave this open for everyone as well. By making this, it makes it where anybody can create a developer environment that does not cost the company any money, or any space, any Dataverse capacity space. So those are the three pieces I always do. And one bonus thing I always do as well is the analytics. I always make sure that's turned on. What this does is it basically takes all the analytics from each of those environments and it consolidates it into one panel for you to look at. And now for our number three item to change. To do this, we're going to go to a given environment. So I'll just go ahead and find a developer environment or maybe a production environment. How about that? There we go. I'll select this production environment, and I want to go through a few of the settings that you'll want to adjust as well. I'll go to my settings area right here. Then I'll go over to product and features. Inside of here, you'll see a lot of the core features that you're going to want to adjust as an admin or your users are going to want to adjust. The first one, as I scroll down, is going to be the map feature here. Now, right now, the map feature is turned on in my case. And when you do toggle it on, it's going to have you accept a license agreement. It is a free feature to turn on. However, it does require that your data goes over to the cloud and then comes right back. The data is not stored in the cloud, but it is from a geo fencing perspective and geo pointing, it will go through and actually send those points to the cloud to figure out where in the map to put that at. I also turn on Bing Maps from a betting perspective, so my model-driven apps can have the maps integrated in there. Now, from an admin side also, there are a few things that you're going to want to set that are really pretty important here. If this is a production environment, I always set this setting right here to be on. This will make it where you cannot install unmanaged code. In other words, code that is not really meant for production. Unmanaged code means you can change anything in that code live in the environment. So I only want my production environment to allow managed code only. So that way I cannot change that code in production and have to veer away from development. I also turn on things like data validation as well. Those two settings are real key meters and are always adding more inside of here. So make sure you come back here frequently to check the settings inside of here. So for our number four thing to do is going to be to go through and set up the Center of Excellence Toolkit. The Center of Excellence Toolkit allows you to go through and consolidate all the reporting, and it gives you a slew of really good applications. You'll find the link of this in the description of this video. And what you'll basically go through is download this managed code, install it into its own environment. It will then go out there and start to inventory all of your other environments and consolidate that into one panel of glass for you, as well as give you a lot of admin tools to make your life easier. One of those admin tools, for example, if a person leaves, you're not gonna have to whip out things like PowerShell script. You can use this application to reassign all of her apps to somebody else, or flows to somebody else. Our number five thing to address is going to be a DLP policy. Going back to the admin center, you're gonna find under policies and data policies, DLP here. Now, I've turned mine off temporarily here. Now, this is a breaking change, so make sure that before you do this, that you find out what applications are using certain kind of connectors. You can do that, by the way, under Analytics and Power Apps and Power Automate. There's a connector tab there that will walk you through how to do that. Now, when you create a DLP policy, what I like to do is keep out my enterprise apps from certain environments. I want all of my enterprise apps to go into things like my dev, QA, and prod environment, and not inside of personal productivity. So to do that, I'll just create this delete me policy here. All right, hit next. And then I'll go through, and what I wanna do first of all, is I'm gonna go through and find out what is blockable. Now DLP, this is not a DLP full demo here. I have a whole video for that if you'd like to see that. It's in the description of this video also. But if I do this, what I can do is go through and say, yep, let's go ahead and block any of the connectors that are blockable. So that way all of these 1,200 connectors are not going to be allowed to be used unless they're in the dev, QA, and prod environment. We can also go through in here and specify what servers are allowed to see. But inside of here, I'm also going to go through and set the default group and say as they add new connectors, I'm gonna block those as well. Now, after I do that, I'll hit next. I'll leave custom connectors alone for the purpose of this meeting. And then I'll go over here to scope and I'll say, yep, let's go ahead and do this for all environments except for my dev, QA, and prod. So now I'll go out and look for my CRM environment as my prod environment. I'll then look for my developer environment, for example, boom, boom, boom. Okay, I'm just pretending here, of course. And then as I do that, we'll go ahead and hit the, we'll go ahead and add those to the given exclusion policy. So I'll hit add to policy, and these two environments are now part of my exclusion. I forgot to add my CRM one. Oh, let me go one more time here. There we go. Select it, add to policy. So we can always adjust this later, but these three environments now are part of the exclusion policy now in this case. And when I hit next, I can now see that this is my total package here. I can come back later and re-finagle these if I want to as well. But by doing this, it's going to prevent those paid connectors, the non-personal productivity connectors, to exist in my default environment. And then I can go through and open those up in the environments I do want to allow them into. It's going to encourage your users to use the proper environments for the applications that you wish. So in this video, we showed you the five things to do as a new admin in a Power Platform environment. Now, there are a ton of more things that you want to do, and you can find more videos like this on our channel, or you can find our Admin in a Day class at pragmaticworks.com, where we walk you through the full day of things to do as a new admin also. Thanks for watching this video. Have a great day.